Hey everybody, welcome back to more Lunar 2 Eternal Blue Complete, where last time we completed the Ghost Manor that's right in that corner there, and we got Lamina in our party. Lamina is a magic user who has a bunch of different stuff. In this case, she has flame spells as well as ice spells, and she has power flame, which is essentially just, I get more attack power, as well as magic seal, which prevents an enemy from using magic. So essentially we got single, zone, and then all, so that kind of just increases in the MP as you go along for each one, and they're different elements. Her equipment just gives her like a standard magic staff, which does non-elemental damage when she attacks. It's actually a lot more useful than you think, compared to having a spellcaster just have a wand and then just smacking someone with it. In this case, it's kind of useful. But for now, welcome to the Banded Butte, or otherwise known as the Banded Butt, because it's spelled B-U-T-T-E. It just looks like the word butt, and that's funny. But you know, this area has a couple of new encounters. It's a short little pass-through dungeon, nothing really too much to worry about. But our first encounter that we're dealing with is man-eaters, three of them, and a killer buzz. So killer buzz isn't doing anything too fancy at the moment, but the man-eaters, both of the ones that are like this, where they're like that, when they attack, they're going to attempt to poison us. If the killer buzz is doing a different animation, it'll attempt to try to paralyze you, and that can get a little bit annoying, but it's not too big of a deal. Every enemy here is just weak to pretty much any sort of magic that you may have, so go ahead and just kind of swing whatever you got. Honestly, at this stage of the game, it's really not that big of a deal to just kind of be wasting your magic. But in this case, if we look at all the stuff here, they're weak to ice, and they are weak to fire. So we can kind of just experiment with Lamina here and see what she does. We get a little bit of an ouchie out, nothing made there.
Gypsy magic!
We got a poisoned bee. That is more hilarious than I think would be. There we go, everything on screen gets hit. The bee is gone. Offer goes for a smack, gets rid of something. And then these things are going to attempt to poison, which they got on fire at least. Lamina kind of has the issue of being really slow, so she's more than likely going to go last always, unless if she's using an item or something. But yeah, so if you're expecting her to go first, don't. So just keep her in the back row just in case, so she like doesn't get hit. And then when she goes last, more than likely than not, she's still in the back row. She might not get hit by something, and she'll at least get something to go off of. So Parasite is another enemy that's new here as well. When it's kind of flailing about like this, it's going to try to hit everybody. So try to get rid of that thing as soon as possible. So just kind of swing at it, whatever you may have that might do damage. In this case, Boomerang does minor damage. Anger Dice goes. So those two might go first. We can kind of maybe swing at it with Jean as well. It doesn't really do that much damage, but might as well just do that. And then just have her just do whatever, because at this point, they're weak to both for subbing. It's to kind of showcase how good she is when it comes to spellcasting.
Dodge this.
Do some damage to you. And hopefully I get a good roll.
Lady Luck be kind.
If not, people are going to get hit. Not that it's that big of a deal. Like I said, this area isn't that bad. And wasting magic gear isn't that big of a deal because it's just a pass-through dungeon. You don't have to worry about it too much. There you go. And we're probably going to get a interruption or a counter from Lucia, just in case if this doesn't kill, but more than likely it's going to. Yeah, it's fine. Not a big deal. So Lucia didn't do her thing again. But yeah, I do like the design for the pass-through dungeons. Technically, this was a dungeon in the original as well. The pass-through dungeons in this game kind of serve to actually level you up because there's no random battles in the field. So you just get level up as you go through these pass-throughs and such. The last new enemy around here is the Killer Shroom, which in this case, they're not really doing much of anything. They're just kind of standing there. They're just going to do a standard attack. But if they're like looking like they're about to unleash spores, they're going to essentially attack in a zone radius around them. Sort of like how our zone attacks work, where it only hits around a certain amount of enemies. Same deal here, except it's on the enemy side. So if you're not near them when they go to do something like that, you're totally fine. In this case, I'm just going to, you know, burn them all, get rid of them. Lamina has more than enough MP to do that, so as long as she doesn't get paralyzed by the bees or anything like that, we are totally fine. This battle is more than well enough done already, even though I'm not even close to being done. I love the fact that most enemies just have like poison status animations like that. It's really nice. So I'm not gonna lie, both of the characters getting paralyzed from the attack, slightly annoying, but not a big deal because this is, I'm already won this battle, so I'm not really too concerned. Oh yeah, and there goes the burned, and everything's gonna die. Ooh, I got an item drop. That's nice. I don't really necessarily need it right now because outside of battles, you don't really need to heal statuses. That's only for an in-battle thing. But either way, head up north from here. We have another enemy I'm going to tackle really quickly. So we have not that... Nah, the setup's not really that great, honestly. So I'm just going to sit there and try to get them with Squall. You use Anger Dice on the one in the back here. You use Moth Dance over here. And then, actually what I want to show off is that when she attacks with her stabs, it does actually have a element attached to it. Like all these are green. That's because whatever staff she has on, in this case she has the standard staff that she uses, it does non-elemental damage. It's still magic damage, but the nice thing about it is it's just like using like a staff item in other RPGs, where if you go into your menu and like say an item has a magic attack applied to that item and you use it and just like goes off and does like a strong magic attack. In this case, it's the same deal, except she just uses the attack out as magic. So non-elemental damage, just swing with the staff. And it's ranged too from anywhere, so she doesn't need to move. She's just gonna stay where she is and then just do the attack. It's actually useful if you were out of MP and you need to do some damage. There are many uses for this, despite the fact that you wouldn't think to do so. And Ronfar is dead. Okay, I probably should have healed that, but that's fine, I suppose. Here we go, Lamina going to attack, using the non-elemental damage, and then whack. Does a decent chunk because it was weak to it, so it is pretty decent to use. Otherwise, I could have won this battle already by having her do, like, actual magical damage, but that's totally fine. I don't need to waste my MP all the time here, because there are still more enemies to deal with. I still have more screens, but I think I'm fine with the MP usage, honestly. Either way, let's continue forward. Okay, now that I'm out of the battle, I can actually heal like I wanted to do in the first place. So I'm going to do this on you, just so I don't have to waste a ton, and then just do that to get everybody. Because now healing to do one person at a time with a party of five is actually going to start being a little bit more costly than just using Kamalini, which is all for 12. Because if you're doing this on everybody, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's just more. So it just depends on how you want to use your magic at that point and how much you're spending. Now we have the Shiro Crest. This might come in handy. The Shiro Crest is just another crest. In this case, we had the, where is it? The Snake Crest, which enables poison magic. In this case, this one increases the user's range, so their range goes up, but their wisdom goes down. One actually cool thing about this is now we have access to a feature called Crest Combinations. We don't have any fancy combinations yet, but the nice thing about the Shiro Crest is if we combine it with the Snake Crest, it actually cancels out the negatives that the Snake Crest gives. So with this combination, it's like, oh, we get the attack buff plus the range buff. So if you combine the two, you get both the buffs on both the crests without losing any of the negatives, which is kind of nice, but it is kind of pick or choose. So in this case, I do want more range, but I don't want Hero to have the poison magic because I don't think he really needs it exactly. But honestly, Ronfar could use the range now that I think about it. Jean and Lamina don't need it, period. So as long as I can give it to somebody, somebody has it. All right, that's kind of a big group, so I am just going to go for... Yeah, see if I can get all three of them right there. And then... Just attack. Just attack, you're not really going to be doing anything. And then you get the one in the back, and then you, once you're going last, you're just going to hit everybody. So technically, I could just save my MP of everybody else here. And then just have Lamina take care of it because she's going to eventually take care of it. That's so funny. I love the idea of a shroom that spews pollen and potentially could like paralyze people and stuff like that. It's poisoned. I love that enemies have status effect animations. It's some sprites you probably would never see if you're not using status effects at all. You just won't see those extra little details. There we go. Everything's down. There we go, and Jean gains a level. But also, she gets Butterfly Dance. Moth Dance more so than Butterfly Dance. Cool thing about this was in the Sega CD version of the game, you had your magic spells, but you also had magic experience that you would get from battles as well. You would use that magic experience to level up your magic and they would get stronger, but they would also give you new magic when those magics leveled up. In this case, though, they just morph the old ones into the new ones, which I think is all right. But the problem is now is that it costs more MP to use it. But the thing is, though, it's a zone attack, so it's still worth it because the MP usage here isn't that large, honestly. And she has a lot of MP anyway, so it's still pretty useful. I mean, you're hitting more enemies for like 9, not a big deal. Though one major contention about the magic experience system, which I might have already brought up in an earlier episode, but Working Designs decided to add in the US version that you needed to use magic experience to save. It got to a point where it wasn't really that big of a deal anyway at some point, but in the early game, it could have been a bother because you're trying to get your spells up and it kind of got slightly annoying, but not too big of a deal, honestly. The nice thing about the magic experience, though, again, is that you could choose what you wanted to level. So if you're not using some spells, for instance, you don't have to bother putting magic experience into it because you don't use it. So what's the point? Which I did like that, but at the same time, you don't get access to your entire move pool if you're not using it. So you may never discover your good moves unless you actually start pumping experience into moves you never bother even using anyway. Which I guess I could see that being like annoying too, but I do like the idea because it does let you experiment. That being said, there actually was something else they took out. In this area specifically, there was an extra boss in the Sega CD release that they took out of the Saturn and the PlayStation versions, which, yeah, that can be like, oh, I'm missing content because they took out a boss. I highly approve of this change, honestly. Not because I'm not fighting a boss, but because it was stupid. Because it was a gunslinging samurai that literally just comes out of nowhere called the Phantom Sentry. It was really stupid. And when you beat the boss, he just makes a cryptic comment to Lucia. And nobody questions it. It makes zero sense, and it just comes right out of nowhere, and I'm so glad they cut it. Because it doesn't even become important until very, very late game, and even then, it's still pointless. So it's like, why does it exist? So I like that they changed it, and just made this more of just a pass-through dungeon, because it was wholly unnecessary. And I'm pretty sure that's why they cut it entirely, because, yeah, what was the point of it? It comes literally out of nowhere, you have no warning, and it's just like, just cut it. Just get rid of it, no. All right, and down we go. Back into another cave. Now, there was an extra enemy over there, but it's fine. Not to beat every single enemy in order to get through this game. Right over here, we have another chest, which this one has a starlight. Yeah, they definitely come in handy. You don't really want to waste those. Just head right over here. Get another enemy group over there. Another enemy group over there. And one that I'm not really able to avoid. All right, and we're just about out of this cave right over here. And one more screen to deal with. Just outside on the other part. Got some enemies right over there. Can't really avoid them. Okay, now I probably should heal after that one. Let's see, I'm just going to do one of these. That ought to do it. I love the fact that the frame rate here takes a dive just because of the haze effect. Wind staff. I have two enemies on me, so I can't really show it off in equipment. But what I could do is something that's actually kind of neat to this game as well. So let me just attack. You can use anything, really. Go after one of those. You do butterfly dance on these. And Lamina here, if you want to swap weapons, you could just go into your equipment screen, click on it, and you'll be able to change the weapon. There you go. And you can still attack on the same turn. So all these are like yellow damage to this because it does one damage, right? So it's like, okay, that didn't really work out. I just kind of swap back and then I could just check and see what it is. Not that it really comes up too often, but it is an option for Lamina to do that. Other characters, you could do it too, but at most points, you're probably going to have the best weapon that you want on anyway. I really doubt there's a point where you're probably going to swap out to like a dagger to do a little bit more attacks. I mean, I could definitely maybe see it if you want to get rid of a group really quickly. Or just not spend time, like, wasting another turn or to attack again. Alright, and I should be able to get away with just attacking everything, so just boop, boop, and boop. Okay, so, darn it. And here we got a level, nice! Not that bad of a battle, and we are just about done. One more enemy to deal with. Aha! I got around you. We're good. Alright, so that's the Bandit Butte. And if we go right over here, this is a little bit of weird path because it's like you can't go down there. You have to kind of weasel your way around a little bit. A little wonky, but then you get to this. This is a town called Noda. Alex, excuse me. Is it all right if I talk to you for just one moment? I promise I won't keep you long. Just wanted to share the glory of the goddess Althena with you and request a small donation. Here we go again. What do you know of Althena, human? Can you lead us to her? She doesn't know where the goddess is, Lucia. She's just one of those chosen kooks. Yes, their shrine in this town is a little itty-bitty house that they commandeered. This used to be my house until I gave it to Althena's chosen. Yep, you even have like a little bed there. Now my home is used to serve the goddess Althena, and that makes me very happy. I have gladly given everything I own to the Chosen in exchange for the salvation of my soul. You gave your house away? Don't you understand the value of home equity? A word of advice, don't give away either of the two brain cells you have left. Good words to live by. We're working hard on casting aside our earthly desires to pursue our dream. Our goal is to collect enough money to build the largest shrine in the world. The largest shrine in the world? That has a nice ring to it! Just like I'm called the richest girl in the world, or the most beautiful girl in the world. But my goal is to be called the legendary leader of the Magic Guild of Vayne. Don't you think it's wonderful to serve the goddess Althena? I guess so. I'm sure that Althena appreciates your positive attitude. I'm sure that she also appreciates your determination. Hey, what are you doing? These guys are frauds. We're going to use that money to buy fish. The other option is just like, nah, and then she's like, ah, I'm mad at you. And then Ruby says the same exact thing. So I'm not going to bother clicking on that one. Welcome to the shrine of the great goddess Althena. Our shrine is smaller than the ones in the neighboring towns, but what we lack in size, we make up in zeal. If we keep receiving donations, of course, we'll expand the shrine. How I look forward to that day. And then you. There was a time when East and West Noda got along very well, but then someone compared the two halves of Noda to Lunar and the Blue Star. It was an instant comment, but it caused a rift between the East and West that continues to this day. Which half of Noda was the Blue Star, and which half was Lunar? The debates raged on and on. And now East and West Noda might as well be separate towns. It's a pathetic situation. Kinda. But at least you got a really long bridge to work with, I guess. Just gonna posterity check there. I can imagine your town being split into being kind of annoying, but Hey there, welcome to the trading town of Noda. Here you'll find almost anything your little heart desires. Almost anything. Far to the east of Noda and directly north of Zakar is an ancient ruin. I have long since been intrigued by that mystery. Why were they constructed? And by whom? Alas, I've never been intrigued enough to explore the ruins myself. I fear what might lurk within. Maybe those ruins are filled with mounds of old treasure. Let's go and find out! Yeah, maybe those ruins are filled with the remains of money-grubbing adventurers. Besides, that place is rumored to be crawling with the undead. And I don't like what I can kill. More words to live by. I mean, there's no guns in this period. So, technically anyway. So, no headshots for zombies. Never seen my precious Julia so sad before. It's as though she's always on the verge of tears. All I want for my daughter and all I've ever wanted is for her to be happy. I know that my husband wants Julia to marry the mayor of West Noda, but he doesn't realize that... Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to burden you with problems that obviously aren't your concern. Well, they might be at some point. Haha! Life is beautiful, my friend. Just look at Julia, my lovely daughter, for the proof. After she marries the mayor of West Noda, she's going to live a life of luxury. This wedding will also begin a new era of cooperation between West and East Noda. The daughter of East Noda's mayor marrying the mayor of West Noda. How splendid it is. You're going to be the most famous leader in the history of East Noda, and it's all thanks to Julia. pretty much having your daughter be in an arranged marriage, I can imagine that's not fun. I'm going to grab this really quick. Gauss's necklace, or Gauss, I'm not exactly sure. Marriage between Julie and the Mayor of West Noto will be a wonderful occasion. I already purchased a wedding present for Julia from a traveling merchant I've known for years. Shouldn't tell you this, but I jumped the gun and gave it to Julia already. It's a magical crystal. The ability to capture and replay the memories of whomever is holding it. How splendid! That could probably be why this person's flickering in and out. As the daughter of the mayor of East... I said that right. As the daughter of the mayor of East Noto, I have responsibilities and obligations. I marry the mayor of the West Noto. Oh, there's a comma there. Noto will be united, and everyone in our town will prosper. And no one would benefit if I just married someone else. No one but me. Can't let down my father. I have to go through with this. I know it'll be for the best. Forgive me, Kyle. Can I click on this? Nope, it's just a person I can walk through. Should definitely keep this in mind for some point later. Oh, Kyle. I don't mean to interrupt, lady, but why are you staring at that crystal? It's a memorizer crystal. When you hold it, you can revisit your most precious memories. And there are certain memories which I can't stop watching. The Rememberizer Crystal is an item that you will get in Lunar 1 that will allow you to watch cutscenes in the game. Keep that in mind, because we might be able to do the exact same thing here. I'm a third generation merchant. My grandfather taught my father and me all the tricks of the trade. Gramps was never happier than when his customers were happy, too, and I feel the same way. Hey, come on over here if you got the time. And if you don't got the time, make the time. Have you ever seen a fish like this before? Didn't think so. This little beaut is from the Minnea Sea. It's the rarest and most delicious fish in the world. And if you don't believe me, go on and have a bite. Delicious fish? Those are the most beautiful words I've ever heard. Let's have a bite. Yeah! Small request. Red, aim your flaming helicified exhalation away from my head next time. They're really getting the use of that portrait and I love it. Hey, mister, do you know the name of the Dragon Master? He's the greatest of the four heroes. I don't want to be a merchant like my dad. I want to be a Dragon Master and work for Althina. The Dragon Master does not work for Althina exactly, but sure. Also, I know there's like a pot right here, but every time this guy moves, it looks like his head remains. It's so weird. Also, I want to talk to you again. Did I forget to mention that I basted this fish in my very own special spicy sauce? I might need to cut back a little on the spices there and I'll start breathing fire. I mean, you didn't do it. Ruby can breathe fire, so it's kind of funny. Why, if that isn't the cutest little kitty cat I've ever seen, is it for sale? Ooh, Ruby? I'm sorry, miss, but Ruby's my adventuring assistant, and she says she's not a cat. I'm not a cat hero, and I'm not your assistant either. I'm Hero's girlfriend! Well, it is okay to love your pet, but it's not okay to love your pet. Perhaps some pyro will help punctuate my point. I am not Hero's pet! Simmer down, Ruby. Remember how much silver Grandpa had to give the last person you toasted? Say, what's a nice bunch of kids like you doing a dive like this? I don't know, I'm talking to everybody. Oh, well, make yourselves comfy. That sounded like it was a response to me. Everyone's welcome here, whether they're nice kids or old coots. What do you think I've noticed so far? Have you bought anything yet that you don't really need? Those merchants of the West Noto make me laugh. Went over the talk business, and all they wanted to talk about was the proper procedure. You don't have to do everything a certain way. They're very big on tradition and ceremony. I try to explain that customers don't care about procedures, and that they just want good prices. But I came back here when I realized they never changed their minds. Fools, all of them. I traveled to a lot of places in my day, but East Noto is my favorite. Ladies here are just beautiful and flirtatious. I just want to take them all home with me. Some people think this place is too crowded, but I like it because it never gets boring. Just make sure you keep a nice tight grip on your wallet when you're walking around town. I'm sick of Althina's Chosen coming into this tavern to curse out me and my fellow drinkers. They're always telling me that what we should and shouldn't do, just like the stiffs in West Noto. I'm proud to live in East Noto, where I can do what I want, when I want. Where did the Chosen get off asking for donations? The goddess lives in our hearts, not our wallets. Exactly? I mean, the first little bit about, I don't know, people drink, it's fine, it's something people do. I'm not really going to complain about that. I'm a traveling merchant, I make a point of getting plastered every time I visit. Speaking of drinking, let me tell you, the ale in this town is strong enough to get the job done very quickly. I also make a point of spewing trunks in every tavern I visit, so you might want to back away. Hey there, strangers. Welcome to East Noto's Finest Tavern. You all look a little young to be here, but I'm sure I can slip you guys a couple of drinks when the barkeep isn't looking. Why don't I start you off with some of the local ale while you take a look at the beverage list? We have an assortment of fine liquors from around the world. You can't leave here without trying the Running River. It's the most famous drink in Noto. We also just received the bottle of booze from Zulan, and the fumes alone will get you drunk. When you live in a place as cold as Zulan, you need liquor that will warm you up fast. Might as well keep that name in mind for later, because we might be heading there. Oh ho, come on in. Tell me, have you all found what you're looking for? Can't find anything in Nota, it doesn't exist, and that's all there is to it. Merchants of Nota pride themselves on selling anything and everything you could want. What I want is to sit down and rest my feet. All this walking around town has worn me out. Yeah, we're not going to be doing that for a little while. We still have some more places to go. We have up north right over here with more people to deal with. First, let's grab this easy-to-see chest, which has a silver light. You want? Might want to keep that. You look like you're new to the village of Nota. I'm sure you notice our carefree lifestyles. Let's make sure you're not quite so carefree about spending your silver with the local merchants. Your shopkeepers rip you off at every opportunity. And they do it with a smile on their face. Yeah, I'm just going to go into the shopkeeps and actually buy some stuff, speaking of that. So, first we're going to do is buy the only broadsword weapon that they got here. There's nothing else. It's literally just blank spaces. The broadsword. Better for hero. It's slightly better, honestly. So I'm going to buy it anyway. And then what I'm going to do is just kind of equip that and then just sell the old one. So boop, boop. And then longsword. Bye-bye. Thank you for some extra money. And I actually... Oh, yeah. I completely forgot I grabbed that already. So the Goss Necklace. If we equip that... It actually gives us 7 HP, I don't know why specifically 7, per turn when worn. It's kind of nice to have, so whoever you want to actually not take some damage and maybe live on a turn, just give them that. It's nice to, like, say Ronfar is good to have it because he can heal himself up a little bit and each turn. You don't want your healer dying, is all I'm saying. Here we go. If you're looking for armor, you came to the right place. The shops in West Nota are too expensive. Are they now? Yes, so we have the Iron Shield, which I don't have on. That's one of the things you could have stolen from... Not stolen, but I'm thinking other games for a second. That we could have got as a drop while we're on the Dragon Ship Destiny. So I'm just going to pick up one of these. Flare Dress is this. There we go. Silver Robe right over here for you. Iron Helm, which is just for Hero. And then the Silver Bandana. There we go. That's pretty much everybody, and now I'm flat broke. That's fine. I can actually get rid of this saucepan lid and actually use something a little bit more beneficial. And then we got that, a little bit more there. And then we're going to do a little bit of this. I could give him this, but it's weaker, so not even going to bother. And then we got this here. I could give you that. It's hilarious. And then let's see this here. There we go. It increases wisdom as well as magic defense. Plenty useful. And now I'm going to sell... I don't like that. I keep doing that. I'm going to go over here and then just sell all the old stuff. We don't need them anymore. There we go. There we go. There we go. And there we go. It's not a lot of money per se, but it is nice. If we are kind of fiending on money, if we want more money, we always have this to sell, which does sell for a decent chunk. Not that big of a deal if you want it. I mean, the Light Jewel is nice for a quick heal, but it's probably just more worth it to sell. We'll find a better item shop anywhere in Nota. To say anywhere in Nota, and especially not West Nota. So just the usual stuff. I'm not even gonna bother. I have plenty. I'm good to go. All right, more stuff to look at. We have you. I've been a trader since I was old enough to barter, and I'm sick of it. I want a new career. I don't want any more boredom in my life. I crave excitement and adventure in the great wide world. Nota is a busy trade center. Many merchants live in Nota and travel across the world to do business. My trading methods are simple. I buy goods where they're cheap and sell them where they're not. Usually don't travel any farther away than Larpa, because I get too bored on long journeys. I know merchants who sail across the seas apply their trade and increase their profits. Good business venture, honestly. Buy something where it's cheap and sell it for more expenses. I mean, I think there's a term for that. I think it's called like makeship or something. It's weird. It is a nice idea. I just don't like seeing the advertisements for it all the time because it's kind of annoying, but back then, in like, say, times like this, it would make more sense to do that. You look somewhat pale, my friends. Perhaps you'd like to buy some green slime extract? Really quite an effective and safe stimulant and health tonic. The only mild side effect that I've encountered is a complete loss of bladder control. Well then, no. Let's grab this, an herb. I don't expect my supply of goods to last much longer. I just stole them. Now of all that's happening in the world. Haven't you people heard of all the insane developments in other villages? Monster called the Destroyer was romping around Larpa. A statue of Althena was smashing Dawn. And the gates of Takara were closed for a short while. As I said, it's insanity! I mean, that pretty much gave us a somewhat decent plot development of like the entire game so far. My mom always sends me to the West Noda to do her shopping for her. I hate West Noda. Everyone there is stuck up and usually uses big words when they talk to try to sound all smart. The old guy who runs the shop I visit is always nice to me. He's not like everyone else there. The old man gave me free candy last time I went to a shop. Mom scolded me for taking it, saying to stay away from that weirdo. But he's the only nice person in West Noda. And he has candy! There are implications there, but let's not get into them. Please try one of our famous Noda snack cakes, won't you? They're delicious and nutritious. Give me a break! You're not going to sell anything with a pitch like that. Now let's try it again, with a little bit more enthusiasm, a lot more pizzazz. Please try one of our famous Noda snack cakes, won't you? They're delicious and nutritious. Give me a break, you're not going to sell anything with a pitch like that. Let's try it again, it's the same thing every time. Through the west door, there's a bridge that joins the two sides of Noda. This bridge is the only route between West and East Noda. Everyone in the village used to hold their weddings out on the bridge, including my wife and I. Those were wonderful times, but now the bridge isn't used for much of anything. A bridge wedding actually does sound kind of neat, especially if it's in a place like this, where it's split up into the two halves, and it's like reuniting the two towns. I actually do like that concept. It is pretty neat. Plus, this bridge does look nice. What the heck? Oh no! You did well to get this far, but you'll not escape again. Soldiers, restrain our friends. Lord Leo knew that you would come here. You fools stumbled right into our clutches. The fugitives are surrounded, Lord Leo. What would you have us do with them? Hold your position, soldiers, while I come down to assist you in their capture. I know you said that Athena's guard was after you, hero, and you weren't kidding. They don't send the dragon ship Destiny to capture just anyone. I bet I know why the guard is after you, hero. You took out a loan and never paid it back. It's too bad you didn't meet me sooner. The Magic Guild's loans are practically interest-free. This isn't about money, Lamina. This is about Illusia. Leo's trying to capture her and... No time for talk, kiddies. The only way we're getting out of this mess is with our feet. Run! While I could use big words to summarize our predicament, I'll go with this really sucks. We have to leave Noda and get Leo and the guard to chase us. Then we could pass the bridge. Well, hero, why won't we go to the carnival at the north end of Midoriya Plains? Jabin and the others should be there by now, and they have a device called the Magic Arrow. We can use the arrow to fly through the sky, and maybe we can fly right over Noda. Sounds like a plan, Gene. Let's go to the carnival, everyone. You know what's really funny about this? We're standing in the middle of town. They were just chasing us, right? Why aren't they chasing us anymore? Let's find out. That ought to do it. Get out of the way, Spud Boy. I'd rather not try to squeeze around your gigantic gut. Your insults are even duller than your mother, Grunt. I'll be the one to catch the destroyer, not you. Cease your mindless chatter and form up ranks. We cannot begin our search until you do. I'd like to humbly suggest that we not enter this bridge house and get caught by Leo. I love the fact that they're like that. You know what's actually cool about this, too? Did you witness the Dragon Ship Destiny? What a spectacle! This is just what the village needs. Excitement! And I don't care what brought Athena's guard to Noda. I'm just glad that they're here. If we're really fortunate, the guard will destroy something before our very eyes. They actually changed their dialogue. Because that just happened. That's attention to detail that you don't see anymore. Closing the bridge between East and West Noda is going to destroy my livelihood. If I can't travel, I can't trade, and I can't survive. Why has Athena's guard done this? I don't know about you, but I'm ready to get out of here really quickly. Hey there, do you any of you know folks happen to know what's going on? I don't understand why Athena's guard can't use the town entrance just like everyone else. I don't know either, but what we're going to do now is we're going to leave Noda and head east and north to get to the carnival and see if we can get out of here. So, next time Manager plays more Lunar 2, we're going to head east and then north. See you all then.